When one website needs to talk to another website for information, that's an API in works. When someone builds an app and doesn't want to start from scratch, they use APIs. And when you ask a website for information and the answer is fetched for you, that's an API working. Let's tackle an acronym littered all over the interwebs, APIs. API stands for Application Program Interface. You may never actually see an API working in the forefront of what you're doing, but there's APIs working all the time for every app you go to or website. It's behind the scenes connecting data. Imagine web platforms like Facebook, Google Maps, and YouTube are like restaurants. You can access their services in two ways. One, you can walk straight into the Facebook restaurant, post photos right on the wall, or you can go through the Facebook drive-thru. Going through the Facebook drive-thru, you can eat the same food, but you don't actually have access to everything within Facebook. That's like an API. They kind of unlock one section of their tool. Without giving all of Facebook's source code, they say you can tap into this information. You can tap into who people are friends with. You can tap into what people like on Facebook. You can tap into a bunch of different information. An API, with this analogy, is like when news website allows you to comment using Facebook, that's a Facebook API. Or let's just say you go to Pinterest and it gives you options on how to log in and you click on Facebook, that's a Facebook API. Those are all more visible, but let's take another example. Take this Lego girl in her car. She goes through the Google Maps drive-thru and picks up mapping information. She drives up to the Facebook drive-thru, grabs an API for login. She can access data and functions from all these platforms that help her build her own platform. It's a lot easier than working from scratch. Key things about APIs I want you to remember. One, APIs, for the most part, work on the web. Because APIs need to communicate to one another. They need to ask for something and get something in return. They're born to communicate over the web because there's an easy way to communicate back and forth. Two, APIs make building apps a lot faster, true time savers. Rather than build something from scratch, it lets you combine existing tools. And three, APIs make data big, really, really big. Why do you think Facebook opens up an API? Why do you think Google does? That's because now, instead of just collecting information when you land on their site or use their app, they're collecting information when you're using different sites and apps. Google Maps can collect information when you use Yelp, not just when you use Google Maps. So just go to one of your favorite websites and at the end of it, after the .com, say /developers, and you'll be able to see all the documentation they have for developers saying, use our API, integrate it into your system. APIs are awesome. Thanks for watching. Hit subscribe, like it. Let's spread some digital literacy.